This is a question from GATE 2017 from Chemical Engineering, question number 49. The gas phase reaction is carried out in a constant volume isothermal batch reactor. The reaction is A plus B gives R plus S. The reactants A and B as well as the product S are non-condensable gases. At the operating temperature, the saturation pressure of the product R is 40 kPa. Initially, the batch reactor contains equimolar amounts of A and B and no products at a total pressure of 100 kPa. The initial concentrations of the reactants are Ca0, Cb0 equal to 12.5 mole per meter cube. The rate of the reaction is given by minus Ra is equal to 0.08 CaCb mole per meter cube second. The time at which R just starts condensing rounded to one decimal place is dash seconds. So this is a question based on design of batch reactors, and the reference NPTEL lecture series can be found in module 1, lecture 10, design of batch reactors, chemical reaction engineering 1, homogeneous reactors by Professor K. Krishnaiya, Department of Chemical Engineering, IIT Madras. So, let us see the details they have given us. So, they have given that the reaction rate minus Ra is equal to 0.08 CaCb mole per meter cube second. They have also given that Ca0 is equal to Cb0 is equal to 12.5 moles mole per meter cube. Okay, so let us write down the reaction here. So we have A plus B gives R plus S. So at T is equal to 0, we'll have 12.5 moles of A, 12.5 moles of B, and the reaction that hasn't started happening yet. So the product will be 0. And let's say at time T, let's say X amount of A and X amount of B has reacted. So we'll have A as 12.5 minus X. So whatever is remaining after the reaction we'll have. So 12.5 minus x moles of A, 12.5 minus x moles of B. This will form x moles of R and x moles of S. Okay. So let us write this again here. So A plus B gives R plus S. At time t is equal to 0, we'll have 12.5, because this is Ca0, then Cb0 is 12.5, 0 moles of R and 0 moles of S. And at time T is equal to T, we'll have 12.5 minus X, 12.5 minus X of A and B, then X moles of R and X moles of S. Okay, so now at time T, the total moles will be the sum of all these four. So that is 12.5 minus x plus 12.5 minus x plus x plus x. So this is A, this is B, this is R, and this is S. And you know, all the x will get cancelled and your total moles will be 25 moles. Okay, now they have asked us to find the time at which R starts condensing, and the other data that they have given is that when R is 40% of total composition, it will start condensing. So the condensing time, this T, will be when R is equal to 40% of total moles, right? So when R reaches 40% of this total moles, we'll have our time T, which we need to calculate here. Fine. So, you know, what we can do is, we have at time t, the moles of R is X. So, just mathematical calculation here, this moles of, I'll write, moles of R by total moles is equal to 40%, right? So this moles of R is X and total moles is 25. This is 40%. That is 0.4. So now we can use this equation and find the concentration of X or the moles, number of moles, which is X, and that will give us the number of moles of R, S, and from that we can find the number of moles of A and B as well. So let us rewrite this. So X by 25 is equal to 0.4. That means X is equal to 10 moles, right? So using this, we can write, we just found that R is 10 moles, then S is also X, which is 10 moles, then A will be 12.5 minus X, that is 10 moles, and B is also 12.5 minus X, sorry, this is not 10. So A is 12.5 minus X, so that will be 12.5 minus 10, that is 2.5 moles, and B will also be 12.5 minus X, which will be 2.5 moles. Now what we can say here is, this is CR, this is CS, this is CA at time t, and this is CB at time t. Okay. Now, for a second order reaction in a batch condition, we have learned that the rate equation can be written as 1 by CA minus 1 by CA0 is equal to KT. Okay. So, this is the equation for a second order reaction. Now here the actual rate is minus RA is equal to KCA into CB, because our reaction is A plus B gives R plus S. But since they have given that CA0 is equal to CB0 and the stoichiometry is also 1 for both the cases, we can approximate this rate as KCA square. And if this minus RA is equal to KCA square, then minus DCA by DT is equal to KCA square. And if we integrate this, we'll get this simple equation for second order reaction as 1 by CA minus 1 by CA0 is equal to KT. So using this equation, we can solve to find this time t. Okay. So now we have 1 by CA minus 1 by CA0 is equal to KT. We just found out CA from the balance. We'll just substitute the values for CA, CA0 and K, and we'll find the time. So CA is 2.5, CA0 is 12.5, and K is equal to 0.08, which is given in the reaction rate. Now substitute this, 1 by 2.5 is equal to minus 1 by 12.5 is equal to 0.08 into t. If we solve for this equation, we will get time t is equal to 4 seconds.